This should have been the most important G7 in a generation, the first of the recovery, the first with a new US president, a chance for Britain to lead the world, as we did at Gleneagles in 2005 or after the global financial crisis in 2009. But whether on global vaccination, the climate emergency, Middle East peace, or the Northern Ireland Protocol, this summit ended up as a wasted opportunity. The World Health Organization has said that 11 billion doses are needed. 11 billion doses. This summit promised less than one-tenth of that. The headlines of a billion doses may be what the Prime Minister wanted, but it's not what the world needed. The same is true of the climate emergency. This is the single greatest challenge the world will face in decades to come. But this summit saw no progress on climate finance. The communique speaks only of commitments already made and of those yet to be made. There was no plan, let alone a Marshall Plan, to speed up cuts to global emissions. And there was little in the communique beyond existing commitments. Mr. Speaker, this summit was meant to be a stepping stone to COP26. But if anything, it was a step back. It was also disappointing that there was nothing to suggest any progress was made to restart Middle East peace process. A new government in Israel, combined with a new US president, provides a real opportunity to end the injustice and to finally deliver an independent and sovereign Palestine alongside a safe and secure Israel. And the resumption, sadly, of hostilities overnight shows the price of that failure. The summit should also have been an opportunity to resolve, not inflame, tensions over the Northern Ireland Protocol. Mr. Speaker, the Prime Minister may think this is all part of a grand diplomatic game, but Northern Ireland is far too serious for that. When a Prime Minister loses the trust of our allies and trashes Britain's reputation for upholding international law, it's hardly surprising that we're left isolated and unable to lead. Mr. Speaker, despite all this, I've no doubt the Prime Minister will be pleased with the G7 because it delivered everything that he wanted. Some good headlines, some nice photos, and even a row with the French over sausages. But that just shows how narrow the Prime Minister's ambition for Britain really is. It's why this was never going to be a Gleneagles-style success, and why the Prime Minister played the role of host, but not leader, of tour guide, but not statesman. On those terms, this G7 was a success. On any other, it was a failure. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.